Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we are going to have a look at how you can import your own project or object directly inside Twinmotion. To do that, the first thing you need to do is to click on the Import tab at the bottom of the screen. When you click on that, you have that dock that expands towards the viewport. So here now you can click on that plus button, you have that small sentence that explains what you need to do. So here I'm going to click on the plus that will bring up that window that allows me to import either a geometry, create a direct link with one of the CAD applications that support the direct link plugin. We can also import a landscape or a point cloud file. Let's start with a simple geometry. I will click on Open and look for the file I want to use in that tutorial. For this tutorial, I want to use a car. So here I have exported some DataSmith file out of 3ds Max. So I'm going to use this file for this video. After you have chosen the file you want to import, here at the bottom of that window, some options are now available. You have the collapse option that allows you to choose how you want to deal with your geometry. By default, we choose the collapse by material option. That means that if all your walls or multiple pieces of geometry in your project share the same material, once you import your project, all those objects will be collapsed as one big object. In the case of a building, if all your walls across your multiple floors share the same material, all your walls will be converted in a single mesh. If you want to keep the hierarchy from your CAD application, you can choose Keep Hierarchy. You can also choose the Collapse option if you want to collapse everything as a single object. This is really a matter of optimization. Collapse by material is the most used option and the most optimized one. But if you want to prefer to keep your hierarchy, you can totally do that, and it really depends on the kind of project you are working on. There are way more options available in that window, and I invite you to check out our online documentation to learn more about all those options in more details. Right now, I'm just going to set on the collapse by material, and I'm going to click on Import to import my car in my scene. My vehicle has been imported. We can see the different mesh in the scene organizer. Here we have one of the files I've imported. So as you can see here, we have the SM coupé body, and here we retrieve that as a folder in the scene organizer. So here we can see our car that is standing on the starting base that you have inside Twinmotion. You don't need the starting base, you can totally hide that and place the car exactly where you want inside your project. Those folders here are created when you import your asset. When you import your file, you can also totally change the hierarchy. For example, here, I've imported four different files, one for the body of the car, one for the front left wheel, one for the front right wheel, and one for the rear wheels. What I can do now is just select all of them and move them to a new folder. So that way, I have a single folder that I can simply hide and unhide, or that can simply move around like that. Twinmotion can digest many different file formats. So here we can see you can import an FBX, SKP, OBG, C4D, the UDataSmith file that is created from our own plugin, plus some other file formats like GLTF and 3DS. Basically, from any kind of CAN application, we can find a file format that Twinmotion supports at the import. But we also created some direct link plugin for some CAD software. You can find those plugins on twinmotion.com under the plugins page. Here you can see all the plugins that we support, so 3ds Max, ArchiCAD, BricsCAD, CET, CT Engine, Form-Z, Navisworks, Revit, Rhino, ReCAD, SketchUp Pro, SolidWorks, Vectorworks, and we also have a plugin that allows you to import your Twinmotion file into Unreal Engine. But we are going to see that in another video. For this video, I'm going to showcase an example of direct link using the Revit direct link plugin. So here I just launch Revit on one of my files. The first step I need to do is switch to the 3D view. I can do that by clicking on that home icon here. Once in the 3D view, I can come to the View tab, I can click on the Twinmotion button that is automatically installed if you have a license for Revit 2023, and I will click on Open in Twinmotion. That will automatically launch Twinmotion and start the synchronization process between Revit and Twinmotion. Here we have the same window that opens with some of the import settings. So first you can choose if it's an existing project or a new one, and then you have the same settings below that. So it's indeed a new project, and I also want to keep the Collapse by Material option on. Going simply to click on OK now. The first time I'm doing that synchronization, it might be a bit long, because in my case it's a quite large project. But in the future, if I would like to just move a wall or a piece of geometry, only the small changes I'm doing will be sent to Twinmotion, and not the wall project again. So here, as you can see, my wall project has been imported inside Twinmotion. So now, same idea here, I can come to my scene graph, I have a single project that is just my Revit file I've imported. I can also play with the visibility of the element that was at the start of my Twinmotion project, like the starting ground and the starting landscape. So here now, I have visible on my screen only the data that came from Revit. As I mentioned, if I want to do a change inside Revit, so for example here, let's say I want to move that column a bit on the left here. Once I want to update that inside Twinmotion, I'm just going to click on Twinmotion again and click this time on Direct Link Synchronize. That will just send that change to Twinmotion and not the whole project again. The second tab in the import window allows you also to manually direct link Twinmotion to another CAD application. So for example here, I am inside 2ds Max, I came to the Datasmith tab in that ribbon here, and I click on direct link and I click on synchronize. After that, I went into Twinmotion. Here in the direct link tab, it recognized that there is a 3ds Max file called mountain bike. And now if I click on import, it will start the synchronization process. So now I just need to click on synchronize to send the data from 3ds Max back to Twinmotion. The data has been imported, as you can see here. Let me just hide the sphere and come closer to our bike. This option is especially useful if you need to direct link or import multiple files coming maybe from even multiple CAD applications. You can use that option to import any number of files in the same Twinmotion scene. The third tab in that import window allows you to import a landscape, a terrain. As we can see here, Twinmotion supports many different file formats to create a terrain, from 3D file to 2D file. In our case, I'm just going to use that grayscale texture as a PNG file. When you select the texture, you have a few options. You have the size of the terrain that will be imported, so here it will be a 2x2 km terrain. You have the amplitude from the lowest to the highest point. So here we can, for example, set 300 meters. And you can enable or not the smoothing. Let's click on import to import our terrain. So here my terrain has just been imported. If I want to just visualize my terrain, I can add the Twinmotion starting ground, the starting landscape, and the starting base. So here again, now I can see in my scene just the terrain I've imported. When I click on the terrain, now I don't need the dock. Here on the right, I will find options related to the terrain. So I can now further sculpt my terrain manually, and I can also paint or customize some texture. So for example, the cliffside here, we can see a lot of the repetition of the texture, so I can just change the scaling on the side of those mountains. The last tab in that import window allows you to import a point cloud file. There are many different types of point cloud file that you can import in Twinmotion, from TXT to LAS file. I'm going to use one of the LAS file for this demo. There are no options available in that import window, it's because those options are available when you will select the point cloud file directly in Twinmotion. So here I just imported my PodCloud file. Let me take some altitude so we can see the whole project. Same thing here, I'm going to select on the PodCloud file, and as I said here, now you have some options. So you can change the size of the point. So let me actually come a bit closer to our house here. So here we can change the size of those points. We can also change the shape from square to circle. And there are a few more options. Like here, if you don't want the texture, you can switch to a solid color, or you can switch to the elevation. Finally, the last thing I wanted to mention in that tutorial is that you don't need to come to the dock here and expand that dock panel. You can go on the file, click on import like this. That way you can keep having a large viewport available. And that covers it for this Twinmotion tutorial regarding how to import data inside Twinmotion. Thank you everyone for watching it, and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!